After leaving the first supply station, this part of the route is a gentle uphill slope, giving our riders a warm-up before the upcoming mountainous roads. The team unexpectedly finds a cyclist who's attempting the challenge on a U-bike. That's pretty brave. Next on the route, they'll ride from Provincial Highway 7 to Highway 7A, which is the Ilan branch of the Central Cross Island Highway. This is the best route to Lishan and Wuling Farm. After passing through Qilan and crossing the Lanyang River, the initial stretch of road is undulating but maintains a gentle slope. Continuing to the 7 kilometer mark on Highway 7A, there's a milestone symbolizing the lucky number 7. Which is a popular spot for cyclists to take photos. At this point, today's mileage has already reached the halfway mark. Next up, everyone will face a series of uphill stretches. After climbing around 100 meters, there's a faint smell of soil and fertilizer in the air. This is Maoan Village in Datong Township, Ilan County. What comes into view is a spectacular highland area rich in vegetable cultivation. The vegetables are grown on vast terraces along both sides of the road. The cyclists arrive at the local activity center and have a short break to replenish some energy. The organizers also have popsicles for everyone to cool down and replenish some sugar. After a brief restock, the team will once again cross the Lanyang River. After crossing the Jiguang Bridge, the next 2 kilometers have a continuous ascent of nearly 160 meters, with inclines reaching up to 12% in some places. It's a real test of everyone's endurance. This is today's toughest and most grueling challenge. Passing through a series of winding U-turns, the surrounding cabbage fields act as unconventional landmarks. This place is known as the hometown of cabbage. This is Nanshan Village in Datong Township, Ilan County. At an altitude of around 1,200 meters, the temperature here averages 6 degrees Celsius lower than the plains. The cabbage grown here is crisp and sweet, making this a famous area for vegetable production in Taiwan. Besides that, it's the largest village along the route to Wuling Farm. The organizers have set up the lunch station here. Here, the cyclists can help themselves to a bento box as well as drinks. It's time to take a break, have a meal, and regain some energy after this morning's ride. There are quite a few cyclists who choose not to eat. After a short rest, they continue on the road towards the finish line.
We think it's very great, that's why we come back, right? Because the landscape is so beautiful, and you have about 90 kilometers above 2,000 meters, so it's super beautiful.
In your memory in Taiwan, like, what's a like really long and hard, iconic, you know,
what is the best?
Why?
Well, it's here, right? So.
Here,
yeah. Here.
From
Wuling to Hohenshan, yeah, it's very, very beautiful. Mm.
So this one's the best?
Yeah. Absolutely.
After a good rest, everyone's full of energy and ready to push on. The upcoming stretch isn't easy, with an average climb of around 250 meters every 5 kilometers. After entering the mountains, fog gradually envelops the surroundings along the road, leading to a noticeable drop in temperature for the cyclists. This truly tests everyone's physical and mental resilience. After a 15-kilometer ride, the cyclists have reached the Siyuan Pass at an altitude of 1,945 meters. This is the highest point at the border between Ilan County and Taichung City. The organizers have prepared hot coffee, candies, and cookies for the cyclists to warm up and refuel. After a brief rest, it's time to head towards today's final destination, Wuling Farm, located in the rural Heping district of Taichung City. With a nearly 12-kilometer downhill stretch, everyone can relax and glide slowly, enjoying the afternoon sun and breeze. At County Highway 124, simply follow the signs towards Wuling. In about 3 kilometers, our riders will have reached today's destination. Along the way, the cyclists will pass by the boundary marker of Xueba National Park, which is also a popular spot for cyclists to take pictures. Not far from the Wuling Toll Station, there's a grand building nestled amidst the mountains and forests. That's today's final destination, the Wuling Farm Guest House, where everyone will stay tonight. After arriving, cyclists line up at the service desk to get their finisher's stamp. Today's challenging mission is officially completed. The riders can find some respite from today's soreness and fatigue.
三位今年都是第一次去，对，第一次。那目前你们觉得这一段环台，今天骑完的心得，就是觉得哇，越来越佩服我自己了，这样子，觉得自己好厉害哦，好感动，我骑都快流眼泪了，你知道吗？就这样。所以这一段对你来讲算有点困难，就是要最后需要意志力了，意志力。
To me, it's a way of traveling to visit places. At the same time, it's a lot more involved, right? You actually get to know the locals. There's a lot more interactions than a bus tour, or yeah, it just has a lot more depth.
Well, I moved to Taiwan about 2 years ago, and then I picked up cycling, and then I never been to all these sites and routes, so I just decided to take part and participate. And Fabro organized the whole logistics, and it made it so much easier for people like me, as a foreigner, to navigate the whole logistics, right? So it turned out to be a really nice route today, and I think I enjoyed myself. By Taiwan, I think the people, the culture, and the whole cycling community is just great, right? I think I made a lot of friends here through cycling, so it's been fantastic. I think cycling is the one way that you could, you know, through your own effort, go and see the mountains. Besides hiking, it's much more fun, and you do it in a group. I also run, but cycling has allowed me to make a lot more friends and enjoy the community. And you know, this it's very difficult to come here and run here by yourself, right? But cycling allows you to do that, so it's been fantastic.
Sudden heavy rain brings today's ride to an end. Tomorrow's challenge will be even tougher. Everyone needs to make the most of this time to rest well. The day has just dawned, yet many cyclists have already prepared themselves and taken advantage of the last moments before departure to meticulously inspect their bicycles. With everything set, everyone gets their departure stamp and can begin their ride for the day. Today's final destination is Sun Moon Lake, located in Nantou County.
This is my roommate.
Yeah, nice
Pinky.
To meet you.
Pinky starts riding, starts cycling for a very special and very lovely reason. She starts riding because her husband, because she wants to chase her husband, right?
Yes, my husband encouraged me to join the cycling world.
But he never wait for you.
Yes, but I never give it up. Now I make every effort to train it. And my goal is then he trusts me. Yeah. And in the cycling world, I really see a different kind of people. That seems really incredible. Patient, humble, and never give up.
Yeah. So yeah. Starting with your husband,
yeah.
But why, what encouraged you to keep riding, continue training?
Because I really feel very confident. After I joined the cycling activity, and I see the most beautiful place in Taiwan, and especially the mountain.
Okay, here we go. Today together.
Okay,
let's go.
It seems like everyone's full of anticipation for today's challenge. Riding their bikes and following the organizers' guidance, everyone heads back onto Highway 7A, heading towards Lishan. The following 6 kilometers are a highly challenging warm-up section. A continuous climb of 270 meters awaits. Keep it up, everyone! After crossing the mountain ridge at an altitude of 1,970 meters, the scenery starts to open up. Next, the cyclists will pass the mountain ring villages nestled in the valley. This is the largest Atayal village on the Ilan branch of the Central Cross Island Highway. Besides immersing themselves in the rich traditional indigenous culture, during wisteria season in March to April, the entire mountain town becomes a dreamy sea of purple, adding a surreal touch to the landscape. It's a place that's definitely worth a pause during a cycling journey. After leaving the beautiful mountain ring villages, there's a long winding descent. Everyone enjoys the thrill of racing through the woods. Before reaching the supply station at Lishan, there will be another uphill climb. As the surrounding forest scenery gradually changes into tea plantations and vegetable farms, we're about to finish Highway 7A and ride straight to the first supply station on Provincial Highway 8. It's located at an elevation of 1,956 meters at the Lishan Guesthouse. The Lishan Guesthouse was built in 1965 and is Taiwan's highest palace-style hotel. The building's exterior features a classical antique design. This guesthouse is a unique landmark along the Central Cross Island Highway that visitors must see to get a deeper understanding of Taiwan. After a continuous 24-kilometer ride, cyclists gradually arrive at the supply station one after another. The organizers offer various snacks as well as a Taiwanese specialty, braised tofu, to help the cyclists replenish their protein intake. After a quick energy boost and getting their stamp, the next leg involves another continuous 30-kilometer ride. From Taichung through Nantou towards Da Yuling in Hualien, there's an ascent of nearly 700 meters. Cyclists need to maintain a good rhythm to prevent exhausting their energy before reaching Wuling. There's another interesting spot along Provincial Highway 8. It's located at the milestone of 88 kilometers. Because the pronunciation of aid in Mandarin sounds similar to wealth and prosperity, many people even queue up here to take photos. If it's your first time riding here, you absolutely shouldn't miss this sign.
This is a new friend I just met. His name is Jia Jie. And you ride a U-bike.
Yes.
Between the Central Mountain Range Challenge, all 3 days.
Oh, yes.
Oh my God, it's amazing. 加油. I trust you can do that. Oh. Okay, see you in Wuling, okay?
Oh, see you.
Fighting.
Regardless of biking experience or the type of bicycle, participants who enter the challenge aim to push beyond their personal limits during this ride. Before reaching Da Yuling, there's a grueling continuous climb of nearly 20 kilometers. Managing pace and conserving energy become paramount during this stretch. After passing through the Hehuanshan Tunnel at the border between Nantou and Hualien, the riders will soon reach the supply station located at Da Yuling. It's said that the thick pork noodle soup and rice prepared by the organizers each year are the most anticipated replenishments for cyclists. Since it's not a race, everyone can take a moment to relax their tense muscles after the meal before continuing the journey. The real challenge begins after Da Yuling. The road from Da Yuling to Wuling is one of Taiwan's most classic cycling routes and a definite must for anyone passionate about cycling, a challenge to conquer at least once in a lifetime. At a total length of 10 kilometers and an ascent of over 700 meters, this route maintains an average gradient of over 10%. Completing the entire journey in one go requires immense willpower and endurance. Located above 2,500 meters in altitude, every steep climb leaves cyclists breathless. This stretch is often regarded by many as the Devil's Road due to its challenging nature. As the altitude ascends, the lush coniferous forests flanking the road gradually give way to vast stretches of bamboo grass slopes, expanding into a wide panorama on the horizon. Despite the beautiful surroundings, for cyclists pushing hard on their pedals, there's little enthusiasm at this point. After another 5 kilometers, they'll face an instant steep climb with a gradient reaching 27%. Everyone's stamina not only reaches its breaking point, but their legs must feel like they're on the verge of exploding from the intensity. This segment is where many cyclists give up on the climb. After passing the boundary marker of the Hehuanshan National Forest Recreation Area, the destination is just a stone's throw away. At this point, cyclists still pushing forward have mostly depleted their physical strength, relying on sheer willpower to keep them moving forward.
很累，爬山蛮累的。武岭啊，就是从大屿岭上面，那个是非常陡的。我的目标是不要下来前车。武岭那一段，如果一般不骑车的人，他肯定，我觉得啦，他几乎骑不上去的。现在太陡了，我们骑帅的没差。我只有中间会下来，所以最后一定会惊到。
The moment cyclists reach the highest point of the road, they can't contain their excitement and emotion. Some are challenging it for the first time, while others have attempted multiple times before tasting success. Some have conquered this challenge numerous times. Regardless, the joy of success is amplified by everyone's persistence and refusal to give up throughout the journey.
<笑>啊，这个魔鬼坡，要命！<笑>
After reaching the highest point on Taiwan's roads, take a break and don't forget to snap a photo with the Wuling Pavilion.
U-bike挑戰武嶺成功。哦，對，挑戰這個賽事這樣子，對的，然後覺得很感動的。你在大嶺到武嶺沒有停下來休息嗎？哦，沒有休息。Non-stop,
really?
就是很跟很跟這樣子，很跟很跟這樣子，對，這樣就一直踩。如果很跟的話，你有辦法享受這裡的風景嗎？哦，其實也是可以，因為一路上都
也有人帮我加油，然后也可以一边欣赏那个合欢山峰，然后就觉得说，哦，那个累那些酸痛都值得。你刚刚都这样骑上来了吗？
我们从那个底下骑上来，就这样子的。哇，
不会冷。今天天空好漂亮啊！
不会冷，
不会。这个地方你每年大概是一起一会吧，就有点像同学会。
Wuling, the sacred ground of cycling, holds an irresistible charm for enthusiasts. Without enduring the hellish trials, they cannot fully embrace the beauty that lies before them. Today's challenge is about to reach its halfway mark in terms of mileage. The next supply station is approximately 47 kilometers away. Descending from an altitude of 3,200 meters down to 560 meters, riders can relax and enjoy the sensation of riding through the clouds along the way. Visibility in the mountains is affected by thick fog, and there are frequent bends on the road. It's important to slow down and proceed cautiously when encountering these bends. Descending along Highway 14A, they'll pass through an expansive area adorned with lush greenery, reminiscent of Nordic landscapes. This is Qingjing Farm, located in Renai Township, Nantou County, and it's one of Taiwan's three major highland farms. The expansive grasslands and the sheep are the highlights of this place. After a series of sharp turns, the team will proceed along Highway 14 towards Puli. On this route, there's a highly significant historical site, the Mona Rudao Memorial Park, located in Wuxi. This was established to commemorate the indigenous heroes of Taiwan, who bravely resisted and tragically perished during the early resistance against the Japanese occupation. After nearly 2 hours of riding, they finally reached today's last stop. It's the supply station located before the Guanyin Suspension Bridge. At this station, the organizers have prepared Taiwan's famous delicacy, scallion pancakes, to refuel the cyclists.
During this kind of event, always you can find a good friend. Yeah. Now, probably I think we don't meet each other for 1 or 2 years, but even if you join this event, like, you know, all the friends get together. Good.
After a quick pit stop, the route will pass through Puli on the way to today's final destination, Sun Moon Lake. After entering the urban area of Puli from the outskirts, they'll pass by the Geographic Center Monument of Taiwan. This landmark is positioned at the geographical center of Taiwan and is hence referred to as the Heart of Taiwan. Upon reaching the intersection of Highway 21, they continue towards Sun Moon Lake. Within this final 10-kilometer stretch, there'll be another ascent of 230 meters in altitude. After enduring the intense steep climbs of Wuling, this incline should only be a small challenge for everyone. After completing nearly 140 kilometers of riding, everyone's gradually reaching today's finish line to stamp their cards for the day. Tonight's dinner event includes the annual award ceremony. Additionally, due to a severe road collapse on the Tataka section, the organizers have announced the use of an alternative route for tomorrow's ride.